Heyo everybody, Haku here with my live reaction to the new One Piece chapter, chapter 830, He Who Gets Bet On. And as you can tell, I am mid-thunderstorm here, just woke up, but just woke up and the chapter's out, so time to go. And yeah, He Who Gets Bet On, not sure where Oda's going with these the style. And for the cover we have Rayleigh and some people from the decks of the world. The 500 million Berry Man arc, volume 20, Sabaody Archipelago, and the guy on the far left almost kind of looks like Fujitora. He looks a lot like Fujitora, actually. Yeah, just Rayleigh and a bunch of gamblers. Did we see them at Sabaody? I don't remember seeing them at Sabaody. Okay. A few hours earlier, we've got Jinbei. Straw Hat Luffy is a man who will eventually change the world. This man took their promise to heart. He may still be a bit wet behind the ears, but I sincerely believe that one who will rule the seas will not be any of the four Yonko. Oh, the one that will rule the seas will not be any of the four Yonko, but Straw Hat Luffy himself. And then it's a flashback in the background of Luffy when he lost Ace, screaming, "I'm weak. I'd like to aid in this man and his endeavors. I wish to board his ship and sacrifice this life of mine for him if need be. I assume that these actions will in the end result in a fight for the true freedom of the fishman race as well." Ah, and it's Jinbei giving the speech to his crew. You can see Wadatsumi there. I think you can see Aladdin as well. Oh, now we have a panel of Aladdin. "Over these past 2 years, you've uttered the name of Luffy countless times. If your passion and trust in this man is honest and just, I do not see any reason why you should not turn your words into actions." "Oh, have I really been talking about him that often?" says Jinbei. "Go and follow your aspirations, Jinbei," says Aladdin. "You guys really okay with this?" says Jinbei. "Captain, why would any of us complain?" says random people from his crew. "You're a former officer in Neptune's army, traded that in for a life of a pirate, simply for the opportunity to fight alongside ex-Meriwa slaves like us. Furthermore, you only accepted the promotion to Shichibukai in order to elevate the status of us fishmen as a whole to the entire world. And we know your reasons for joining Big Mom as one of her subordinate crews was not only to protect all of us, but protect our kingdom using her name. Captain, you've always made decisions in your life based on how it would benefit those around you. You no longer need to carry that burden, Jinbei." "Hear, hear. Please think about yourself for once, Jinbei. From this point forward, it's okay to follow your own desires and be a little bit selfish." Man, that was a really good scene. I like that. "Go on, Jinbei." "Yeah, Captain. We can manage ourselves perfectly fine ourselves, so don't worry about us." "I have no words for how grateful I am," says Jinbei. "In any case, even if we all support his decision, I doubt Big Mom will let him off the hook so easily. Worst case scenario, if her rage gets directed towards us, all we gotta do is run for our lives. Bwahahaha. But won't this put Aladdin," is what they're translating it as now, "won't this put Aladdin in an awkward situation?" And now we have a panel. "Vice Captain of the Sun Pirates, Aladdin. Goat's Beard Brachula Fishman. I mean, since he's tied the knot with Miss Praline and is now a member of Big Mom's immediate family and all. So Aladdin is married to one of Big Mom's daughters. Well, shit. Oh, and her daughter's a fishman. What in the hell is this? My, oh my. Shouldn't you boys be a bit more worried about little old me? 29th daughter of the Charlotte family, Charlotte Praline, hammerhead shark, half mermaid. Freaking big pimpin' Big Mom slept with a fish. Oh, gosh. Praline doesn't look too bad, though, actually. You know? Sha, 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 she laughs. Whoa, miss, were you eavesdropping on us this entire time? What, are you lot trying to hide something from me? I thought our relationship was better than that. Eek, Aladdin, don't tell me that you're planning on deserting me. If all this doesn't sit well with Mama... No, if all this doesn't sit well with Mama... No, of course not. I'm sure I'll be able to negotiate with her. Poor Aladdin. Negotiate? There's absolutely no need. You know that I'd choose you over Mama any day of the week, darling. Take me with you in the event that anything happens. Kya, such passionate love, says Jinbei's crew. Forgive me, Wadatsumi. I dragged you all the way out here and now... No, it's okay, because I'm having a lot of fun with everyone around, says Wadatsumi. In any case, Praline, do you truly believe that we'd incur Mama's wrath if I left? Well now, let's see. You wouldn't be the first person who tried to leave. Having said that, not a single soul who was brave enough to utter such words has lived to see another day. Sha 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 sha. Whole Cake Island, present time. Capital, Sweet City. Sir Muscat! Sir Muscat has died. And now they've changed it to Moscato. Please, don't leave us, Sir Moscato. Why'd they change it, though? That's weird. Move aside, says the big, goopy guy from last time. Hurry up and remove the body. Yes, ma'am. Okay, and that's the woman that was with him. Are they Big Mom's other siblings? And now here's the dude that looks kind of like a scarecrow. Do not leave for even a single second. Do you hear me? Hey, Sir Montdor, will Boss Jinbei also be killed? Hell if I know. The only thing I can say for certain is that when Mama flies into a rage, no one is safe, not even her own son. Wow. Sweet City, Whole Cake Chateau. So, you want to cut ties with me, Jinbei? Why, Boss? Please don't leave, Boss, all the little sweets are saying. Squee! Silence. Big Mom grabs one of them and eats them. Man, Big Mom, she's a freaking psychopath. Do not ask those who wish to leave their reasons. How uncouth. I don't give a damn about his reasons. He's a pirate. Living freely is of utmost importance. However, having the bond between one's child revoked is shameful to the parent. Jinbei, your departure would cause a huge void and cost me a valuable and powerful resource. Well, sure, says Jinbei. Don't you shore me. It's only fair that you lose something valuable as well. That's the only way we could call this a fair trade. Wouldn't you agree? Ma 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 ma. Bring in the roulette. Eh? And then she's laughing psychotically. Now then, exactly what will it be? Shit. And there's this weird roulette board that I don't quite understand that you'll be losing, but I see arms and legs on it, so that's scary. Nighttime in the seas within Big Mom's territory. And, it shows where they are on the map. They're between Biscuits and D's Nuts Island. It's so sweet, says Chopper. Can't we just stop here and go to sleep for a while, says Luffy. Are you nuts? Haha. Are you nuts? What are we going to do if those ants start attacking us again? There's a bunch of dead ants floating in the water. This will start to flow once the warmth of the sun returns during the day, says Pedro. But at night, this area gets quite cold and the sea ends up freezing. Ah, that's interesting. And it looks like they're using pitch and torches to melt the sea so they can get through. It would have been nice if you could have mentioned that a bit earlier, says Nami. Everyone, our primary focus will be to melt this stuff, so that we can hightail it out of this sea of Mizuame. So, sweet syrup. Roger that, says Luffy. Just so we're clear, says Brooke, I've only temporarily put that swarm of ants to sleep. It'd be chaos if they woke up again, said Carrot. I once had my ship eaten down to the last plank by these ants, says Pedro. Yikes, but what were you doing in a place like this? Luffy responds. Pedro used to be a pirate, just like Peckham, says Carrot. Okay, so we're finally figuring it out. What? For real? Says Luffy. I honestly didn't know any better at the time, said Pedro. I thought I was simply an explorer, but they ended up putting a bounty on my head. I only accompanied Peckham's midway. I'm only sharing this with you because of the trust that's been built. Ah, Pedro, for Straw Hat. Still, but we were on a journey to discover Poneglyphs. We just wanted to be an asset to our master Nekomamushi in any way that we could. The day we finally stepped foot into Big Mom's territory would be the last day of our journey. The truth is, I've fallen here once before. Yo. And then we see everybody's reaction faces. That is something I've not shared with many. I had no idea, said, Carrot. So this place must bring back those awful memories, said Nami. If my experiences here end up aiding us in our plan to rescue Sanji, I wouldn't have it any other way. Besides, I doubt that my tagging along will turn out to be a waste of any of our times. I was told our Duke and Master showed you all our road Poneglyph. Yup, says Luffy. When I first heard of this, I could not believe my ears. Though you all are saviors, the last time we showed that to outsiders who weren't members of the Kazuki clan was precisely 26 years ago. Feels like ages since we've shown the Poneglyph to Gold Roger and his crew. The Pirate King? Afterwards, Roger made it to Raftel and became known as the Pirate King. I believe that Duke Inuarashi and Master Nekomamushi are seeing similarities between their crew and yours. They must be confident that you lot will become people who will end up needing the Road Poneglyph. What will you do after you defeat What will you do after you defeat Kaido? Well, that's so far in the future, says Luffy. After that, you'll surely need to make use of the Road Poneglyph Big Mom possesses, says Pedro. And if this is the case, you will not have a better opportunity than this, seeing as how we've been able to sneak this far into her territory. It would be wise for you to steal her Road Poneglyph in addition to rescuing your crewmate Sanji. Well, Robin did ask us to do pretty much what you said, so when we arrive at the island, would you mind buying me a bit of time? I promise that I will successfully steal the Poneglyph this time around. What? If it's for our sake, then we'll go with you. No, please focus your attention on Sanji. Things will get far more complicated once you've managed to take him back. Oh yeah, said Luffy. All right then, I'll leave it to you, she. Wait, that sounded too easy, says Nami, and then, Carrot is just laughing and Brooke's looking on. Okay then, that's the plan. And then Brooke said, I suppose Luffy was simply born with this kind of fate. Yo-ho-ho. You say something, Brooke? Oh, nothing. I'm not much different, I guess. You'll get no argument from me. Yo-ho-ho-ho. And then Chopper looks over at the ants, and they wake up. The ants are awake. The next morning, hey guys, wake up. We're here. Whoa. And then, Carrot's looking all surprised. It's Whole Cake Island. It's an actual cake. It's ginormous. So this is the island where a Yonko lives? The tallest cake you can see in the distance is the castle where Big Mom currently resides. Castle? Says Chopper. Nami, should I continue going straight? Asks Brooke. Yes, I've heard that that cape over there is the only location where the security doesn't make their rounds. Oh, there's someone standing at the coast, says Luffy. They're about to set foot on the island where a Yonko resides. I wonder if it's going to be like Jinbei missing an arm or a leg, or if it's going to be actually Sanji and Pudding, or if it's going to be a trap. Lots of options here. I would say those are the main options. It's either a trap, it's Jinbei missing a limb, or it is Sanji and Pudding, but I'm not so sure it's Sanji and Pudding, and if it is, it might still be a trap. So, yeah, man, this one was really good. We'll read it a few more times, as usual, and have the review up tomorrow, again, as usual. So, thank you for watching this one, again, as usual. Thank you for watching. Like if you liked this one. Comment down there and tell me what you thought of the video, tell me what you thought of my initial thoughts and reaction, what you thought of the chapter itself, subscribe for more One Piece, Kiznaiver, Tower of God, Monmusu, Walking Dead, bunch of stuff. Follow on Twitter if you want to, because I'll try to keep you updated there as best I can on when I'm posting stuff, pushing stuff back, whatever. So, thank you once again for watching, and I'll see you all next time.